Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends and glad you could attend. Come inside today as we take a look at the independent horror comedy film called Atom, the Amazing Zombie Killer. Yes, Atom, the Amazing Zombie Killer. Brought to us by directors Zach Bynes and Richard Taylor, telling us the story of Atom. Of Atom and the Zombie Killers. They're a bowling team. Pretty kick-ass bowling team. Their only rivals are Dario and the Slashers. Yes, well, when events occur that get them... possibly threaten them their chances to get to the National Bowling Championship, they have one final game to play against Dario and the Slashers to try to win that spot and go to Hawaii. The only thing standing in their way, well, Atom got a little bump on the head and now he's going around killing what he feels is zombies. And we watch the hilarity ensue in there as he goes around thinking we're victims of a zombie apocalypse, all the while his girlfriend, on and off girlfriend, who is just really high maintenance, is hanging with the other team. Wow, Atom the Amazing Zombie Killer, folks. Let me tell you, anyone who's ever watched a trauma film will watch this and think they're watching something right out of Lloyd Kaufman's vault. Right from the get-go, from the opening credits, you know what kind of zany fun you're in store for. Yes, this is a lot more comedy than horror, but there are plenty horror elements to go around. First, there are the horror references in here. Zach Bynes, Richard Taylor, and Tim Johnson wrote a script that definitely has a lot of references for you horror fans out there, and also a lot of comedy in here, a la the trauma films that we've seen in the past, like Toxic Avenger, and Sergeant Kabuki Man, along those lines. Coming at you nonstop, definitely you can tell everyone's having fun in this film, and knowing what type of film they are, which is just batshit crazy, zany, zombie film without zombies actually in it. I really liked this film quite a bit. One of the things that was impressed me most about it was the editing of this. It definitely had that light, fun feel to it for horror fans out there. You get some great cameos in here. You've got Babbitt Bombshell showing up as Ariola, the Twilight Princess. You got Sean C. Phillips here playing a preacher. And yes, Uncle Lloyd himself, Mr. Lloyd Kaufman, makes a cameo as well as Grandpa. Yes, the grandpa, the bowling champ of Atom, who had passed on, but Atom was carrying on his legacy of great bowling. I also love the fact that they used bowling as the main setting for a film like this. Bowling doesn't get enough, you know, attention, I think. And so I just love the fact that they added that. They added just the extra little bit of humor in there. You got some great performances by Crystal Rose, Mark Shaughnessy in here as Atom. I loved his Atom quite a bit, actually. He played crazy really well. He delivered his lines great. And there were the scenes in there where he was torn between his bros and his girlfriend. And I really liked his performance overall. Everybody in here just seems to be having a whole lot of fun. And you can tell. Now, what's also in here are some great practical effects. Again, definitely done in the style of trauma, over-the-top gore effects. There's a great scene in here with a smiley face bowling ball meeting a head of somebody. Loved that scene. Loved all the practical gore effects in here. There's only like one scene in here that had some CGI gore in there, but by that point in the film, you didn't really care because you're just enjoying this. No, it's not going to be for everybody. But anyone who's a trauma fan up there, Atom the Zombie Killer definitely deserves to be right up there with the other trauma-type films and trauma films of years gone by, we'll say. Okay? This is definitely one that I would see trauma's name on it soon because it just really fits that library and that catalog and fits right in there next to Toxie and Kabuki. Man. So check out, if you can, Atom the Amazing Zombie Killer. Go to their Facebook site. Check out where they're going to be playing next in festivals. I got a chance to catch it first on the Bordello of Horror. Didn't get a chance to catch all of it, but they were kind enough to send me a screener, and I saw the rest of it, and I was glad I did. Yes, it's a lot of fun. It's not humor for everyone. It's crazy, silly fun, but it's definitely made for those who have the vein and the taste and the love for trauma films. This one's for you. And that'll about do it for us here at the Final Cut. Till next time, keep that ticket stuffing.